know, guys. So I really need to catch up on a lot of things. Gonna start with the mission inspiration for December. Yes, I'm that far behind. I still need to do a couple of mixed media morsels, a couple of mini missions. Yeah, very behind because of work. I've got a day off today, so I thought I'd quickly try and get this one done. And I've also been playing with my new craft, which I will probably show you in another video. So I'm just cutting some mixed media paper to size and add texture with tissues or napkins. So which bag did I put them in? Sorry, I've been shopping today. I found a lot of Christmas napkins that are reduced because of the Christmas sale. So yeah, really nice Christmas napkins. That's the last one. Okay, so I'm going to use the poinsettia, how do you say that? Get into this. With tissue or napkins. So if you are on my Instagram, you will know that I have a new hobby, and I've shared a couple of pictures of me playing. And I will talk to you about it. As I say, I think I'll maybe do a video in between filming this. Probably not going to do a tutorial at the moment because I'm still learning, still getting equipment. But yeah, I'd really like to maybe one day do a tutorial. The thing is, with this particular craft, it's very messy. This is why I've had to take my sheet off, because it got covered in stuff and it's all sticky. But I won't be able to do much talking in the video when I'm actually doing the thing, because I need to wear a respirator. The craft is resin, epoxy resin, two-part epoxy resin. And yeah, being asthmatic, I really don't want to take any risks with my chest, which is why you might hear a few bangs and things outside. I've got the window open because I have some pieces curing in the room, so the window will stay open until everything's finished curing and set. And we'll stop playing. I can't stop playing with it at the minute. I have so many ideas and I bought some cool stuff that I really want to show you guys. If you want to get into epoxy resin and you live in the UK, I found something that's just amazing. But anyway, just sticking down this napkin carefully, don't want it to tear. But I am getting all the lumps and bumps in there because this is a texture layer. And that's what we want. Now then. I'm going to let that dry. I think this is going to be quite a simple page from what I've got in my head. Now, where is... I had a photograph. Let me just pause you when I find the photo. Okay, so... we have these, so let's just move this out of the way. I literally, as soon as the camera turned off, I put my hand on it and there it was. I bought these from Craftbox. If you look on their website. They had these. I don't know if they have any left, but they had these. And my photograph, unfortunately, is a little bit didn't print out perfectly, but I should just be able to get. Do we cut the ear off, or do we just get that weird thing in? Yeah, let's do it like that. Get dear little Merlin's face in there. Do I have a knife? I have one somewhere. Wait. Okay, so I can't find the knife, so we'll do it this way. Just take that off. Get rid of that. Thinking it might be kind of nice. We could do like a little shaker. Oh, that would be cute. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that instead. So I'm gonna get some. Ooh, I'm gonna need like glitter and stuff. So I did buy this for doing the resin stuff. We can use some glitter out of here. It's a shame I haven't got any like icicle sequins or anything cool like that. Spoiler for the other video that I'm gonna do. Let's do some hearts. Just a few. Of stars, and then I think that'll do. Okay. It might be too much, but yeah, it's Christmas. Well, it was Christmas. Push all that into there. I'm going to grab some matte gel medium. I'm going around the edge of this. On the inside because the glitter will stick to it. Don't need a lot, just need enough to go all the way around. Sure it's secure and the glitter's not going to come out. There we go. And now I'm going to have to let that set. Try not to get the glitter to stick in, as I say, stick into that gel medium. So, next thing I want to do is add some glitter to this frame, and I'm going to use some glitter glue for that. And just shove this out of the way. Crystal glitter. And a little brush. We got a brush. I would use this one, but it's a bit red. Ah, let's just go for it. I'm just gonna paint that on. Give it some sparkle. Okay, now what I can do is move that over there for a minute, grab baby wipe, sorry about the sirens, Right, and I can bring this over. Grab that gel medium. I'm not going to put anything on this, I don't think. Gel medium is going dry. Do I want to do that? Probably should have waited for this to dry, I think. Oh, well, it doesn't matter if something sticks a little bit. Okay, now it's a waiting game. Gotta wait for everything to dry. And I will find out some ribbon and something for the gambit, and I should be able to put it all together then, I think. How crazy is that? Okay, be back in a sec. See how long we can record without it dying. Battery is flashing at me. So I'm going to try and, okay, let's try this again. Battery ran out. So, I want to try and add a sort of, shall we say, frosted effect around the outside. So I'm going to add some gesso, and I'm going to try mixing it with some of this iridescent medium. Got no idea how this is going to work. Iridescent medium has gone a little bit dry. Try and keep working it, see if it I think I'm going to do is grab, now I've just seen it, where is it, a sponge, going to go really well with the frosted look to this. Oh, I need to glue that down. Thought I'd already done that. here. And repaint that one. I wasn't going to colour this, but it'll be subtle. Stray hairs today. Not sure what that's about. Maybe I'm molting like a cat. That brush in a second. And I'm thinking, why not grab the with glitter glue back. So I'm going to grab the sponge again and just to really get that sparkle. Sorry, I'm hungry. It's lunchtime. There we go. Beautiful. Let that dry. Just grab the rest of that. Add a bit more sparkle to here. There we go. Let everything dry. Let's go and get something to eat. so my tummy doesn't rumble all the way through. And I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so this is literally the only tartan thing I could find in my whole stash. So I do have some tartan fabric, but yeah, it's all blues and yellows and greens. Like bright colours, not Christmassy colours. So let's go with this. About there. So I don't know where that's gone. Okay. Okay, also do not have any twine, so we're going to use this yarn. I'm going to try and make a little double bow. Maybe a triple bow. If I can remember. I always forget how to do this. No, it's not right, is it? Okay, so let me cut the end off here. Pop it down the middle. I think this is how you do it. Bring it down the middle. Tighten the knot. Oh, these scissors need a good clean. Oh. Right. Let's assemble some bits and pieces now. Clean off some excess paint from around here. Right. Using my gel medium. Okay, let's pop you there. Hold that down a few seconds to grab. I've got this in the right place again. Bird outside eating at the guttering. Well, I don't know if he's eating or if he's grabbing moss for his nest. That's probably what he's doing. Why can I never get this back in the right place? Rid of some of the excess. There, oh, that's kind of cute. Oh, looks like a kind of a wreath. Do I put it there or do I put it there? No, I think there's kind of cute. Now I need to figure out what we're missing, if there's anything else. Oh, excuse me, I don't know who that is. Right, so let me just go and have a look at the prompts and we'll finish this off. Okay, so there's two steps I haven't done. Add a little silver or gold and include elements of lace. So, I wish I'd read that before I stuck him down. But I know I have some lace, so well, it's still wet, so I can kind of lift it. Let's see. bag full of lace here. Split all out a second, so I don't want the dark one. Don't want purple. I don't want anything too wide. That's a bit big. I don't think the butterflies will go. No. So we've got this eyelet one. No, I don't like that. Cream one. Not sure I'm gonna like that. It's too bulky, I don't like that. Don't want the rickrack, so it looks like this is gonna be our winner. Let the squirrel clank in that thing. Clank in the wind jam. Alright. So let's lift you a little bit. Okay, and then we can pop some. Let's go with some matte medium, I think. Just try and get that dry. Oh. The gel medium away. Try my very hardest this year to be a tidy crafter. Let's pop it on the side there. This page. There we go. It doesn't have to be perfect. Don't mind if that's a little bit loose. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to go with a little bit of silver. No. Thank you. to some water. Kitty cat's face. There we go. Title. Ooh, knocking everything off the top. What, I can't get into this drawer now. Give me a sec. Okay, so I've typed out my little set phrase that I want to use. Do we want anything else. Red pen. Don't want it to stand out too much from the page. I don't want the pen to stand out from the page, but I want the words to, if that makes sense. Finally finished my mission inspiration for December, and it is actually January. What's the date today? May 10th, something like that. So yeah, Looking at the new Mission Inspirations, I don't think I'm going to be doing them anymore. I really like this prompt base. Sorry, I'm not close now. Prompt-based way of doing things. I don't like just being given a word. That's not why I, you know, how do I say it? I don't do well with just a prompt on its own. With a word on its own, so I would rather have the steps to follow. So I really need to tidy up. So I don't think I'm going to be doing Mission Inspirations anymore because of the format change. I like having the prompts to follow. I don't like having just a word. So, yeah, sorry Mike, it's not for me anymore. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you do want to just continue with the Mission Inspiration, there's a link down below for Mike's Mission Inspiration page. And I hope you have a lot of fun with it. I'll probably still follow what people are doing on there. Who knows, I might do the mini missions. Who knows? But yeah. I think that's going to be all from me for Mission Inspirations. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and see you again soon. Bye guys.